These are five mistakes sellers make when selling their home. Number one, not pricing their home right. A few things go into that. Number one, if I overprice it by, let's say, 5%, and then the buyer's coming off for 5% more than that, now we're 10% more than market value. What's gonna happen when an appraisal comes in 10% below? A couple of things. We're gonna either renegotiate the sales price, the buyer, we need to know they have the cash to close. We should have negotiated an appraisal gap in the contract when we went to contract on it. Or number three, we go off the market and back on. People are then gonna question, why is this house coming back on the market? Yeah, it wasn't the inspections, it was because it was overpriced. Number two reason, that you wanna make sure you price your property right. If your house is worth $500,000, truly worth $500,000 or $300,000, price it at $500,000, maybe $505,000. What'll happen if the buyers see the value in the home, they're going to push the price up. And if they're doing that, they're gonna show you why they have the cash to bring to closing, because they're pushing the price up on the home. And you're gonna get it going to closing. The idea is to not get a contract in your house, but get a contract that's gonna close. And you wanna have, as I talk to people about having the highest and best offer, it's not about the highest or the best, it's about the one that's gonna close. And it doesn't always mean it's the highest offer. It's gonna be the best offer that's there, the best terms that fit you, and that's gonna get you to the closing table. Number two, not preparing your home for sale. The thing you wanna make sure when you're getting your home ready to go on the market, that you take care of, staging the home, whether it's you personally staging or having a stager come in and redesigning the house. When you're getting the house ready for sale, you want it show ready. Think about walking into a model center with all those upgrades. That's gonna make the wow effect, and that's what's gonna help push the value up on your home. And if you do that, that's gonna get you the highest offer, the highest and the fastest close. Something else that people think about is like, I wanna sell it as is. That's also preparing your house for sale. I mean, if I'm gonna sell it as is, I wanna make sure I take care of every little nuance that's in that house that's gonna come up on an inspection. There's things we don't know about, and that's just the nature of the beast. But if I walk around my house and I see a ton of deferred maintenance, what's gonna happen? My price is gonna go down, because people are gonna see that and they're gonna think, oh, the siding's rotted, now I need $10,000 for that. Oh, the door's falling off the hinge. I could have got my drill, fixed a couple of screws, fixed the door. Could have had $500 in siding repairs done and been done, and had it done and looked clean and painted. So it's making the house show ready. And if you have the house show ready, you're gonna sell it faster. You're gonna sell it for the highest dollar. Number three mistake when selling a home is not disclosing major issues. Here in Florida, we have a lot of major issues that can come up. Termites, if you haven't gotten them, you're gonna get them. Sinkholes, they happen everywhere. If you've had those things happen, and again, many others, but make sure you disclose the situation on the disclosures, because what's gonna happen is if somebody sees something after the fact and they come back to you to say, hey, we just found this out. Well, I already put it in the seller's disclosure and you knew about it when you did it. The inspector, if he caught or didn't catch it, you guys have gone to closing. We've given you the information. And I'm telling you from the seller side why we would wanna notify this information. Major issues can be pretty much taken care of, if they're simple. If it's a sinkhole, obviously that's a big issue because it's, refixing a foundation. If it's some broken windows that the balancers are not working, $75 a window, you can get those fixed. Air conditioning's 20 years old and the bottom's all rotted out and you've got mold. Let's get it fixed, because that's gonna help, create a safer sale for somebody. If you've got mold behind the cabinets, again, change the cabinets out, get the drywall replaced and get the mold, cleaned up. Everything is a minor issue until you decide not to take care of it. The biggest thing I can recommend is when you're selling a house, get a pre-listing home inspection done. That way, if you know you have issues, let's find out what all of them are. You're gonna have a guy who crawls behind the walls, crawls behind, up in the attic, and sees things that you don't see on a regular basis, and they're looking at it from a third party eye. Kind of like why we have someone back us up on our values when we're listing a house. That's the appraiser. Does he see the same value that we do? Or the buyer set of eyes. That's what you always wanna look at your house through when you're selling, is the buyer set. If you do that, you're gonna have a successful sale, and disclose, disclose, disclose. Number four, accepting sight unseen offers. That's a big issue for me as an agent. I wanna make sure that the people have seen the house. Yes, there are people who are out of state and can't get down here and wanna buy, which is cool, we accept those, but we wanna know, did they get a video tour? Did the agent see the property? And when we're presenting as on the buyer side, I'm showing the entire neighborhood with my FaceTime. I'm going out and talking about the little things that we see in the house. Are there high tension wires out there? Because if you have a buyer who comes down and then sees the property and says, hey, you know, I don't like the high tension wires in the back, or I don't like the neighborhood, or I don't like the neighbors next door. They didn't see that. And that means what they're gonna do is just say, I don't care about my $10,000 deposit. I'm walking away. I wanna know that you've seen the house, you've been through the house, and that you're a good buyer. Because if that's the case, then I know we're gonna go to closing. Because if you're trying to sell your home to buy another one, you know, that's a huge hiccup on the, you know, the end of the month when you're going to closing and you don't have a closing on yours to be able to buy the next property. So the sight unseen buyers are a scary thing. We have those quite often, and we want to vet those buyers and those buyers' agents before we do accept those contracts. And of course, number five mistake that sellers make when selling their home, not using the right realtor or the right real estate team. That's why we're here. We're the right real estate team that's gonna come in, help guide you through the process, teach you the things that need to be done, help you decide, do I need to make upgrades? Do I need to fix these things? What do we need to disclose? What is simple? And, you know, getting the house priced right and talking you through the contract process to say what is the highest or what is the best offer to accept and how can we get you all the way to the closing table. That's our goal for you, getting you to the closing table. As always, we appreciate you watching this video and learning the five mistakes sellers make when selling their home. If you have any questions about what your market value is, what our strategies are to find you the highest price, the best offer for your home, give us a call. We're always here to help.